Music in the Castle started off as the Southeastern Band Festival, and I think it was 1951. It was the early 50s, and the festival has changed names throughout the years. It's gone to the McDonald's Festival, the Autumn Chase Festival, the Music in the Castle now, but it's been going on. This would have, if it weren't for last year and COVID, this would be the 70th year. So right now it's the 69th time that we've had it. So we're going strong after about 70 years. Well, I always tell the students that this is probably my favorite day of the year. It's where we can really kind of showcase what we have here at Tennessee High, all the great facilities and the standard of excellence and everything that we demonstrate here at Tennessee High. I think it says a lot that we have 30 bands showing up this year. We have bands from North Carolina, we have bands from Virginia, and bands from Tennessee, and they go all the way from like Buncombe County, North Carolina, to Knoxville, Tennessee, all the way up into Southwest Virginia. So we have quite a few bands from three different states. And we're doing an exhibition. We're not competing, but we're performing as well. And we actually have the ETSU Marching Bucks coming to perform for us too. The competition is divided up into five classes. We have the smaller bands going a little bit earlier in the day and the larger bands going a little bit later in the day. We grade on drum major, percussion, color guard, visual, music, and overall band. And so we're gonna have two award ceremonies this year. We'll have one about 4 in the afternoon and then another one at about 9 o'clock. So it's pretty big competition. The competition starts at 10:30. The first band goes on at 11. Ticket prices are $8 for adults. There's actually a program ticket combination for $12. It's $5 for students, and children 5 and under are free. Other than music just being a whole lot of fun, I really think that it builds a lot of character and life skills for the students. It teaches responsibility, it teaches teamwork, it teaches leadership. I have a big student leadership team out here that they learn how to lead, and they make mistakes sometimes, but that's part of the learning process, you know. We talk about performing passionately and performing with pride. And so I think, you know, them having something to, you know, kind of have an outlet for their emotions and an outlet, you know, to kind of get away from the daily stresses of life is maybe the best part about, you know, the students being in band. I probably have 3/4 of the band wanting to pursue some form of music in college, whether that be a music major, a music minor, maybe just playing in the college marching band, maybe playing in the concert band. So it's definitely something that they can continue to do after high school. Many of these students will actually get music scholarships, you know, for the college of their choice. Some colleges are a little harder than others to get music scholarships, you know, the more competitive schools, but I think it's a real opportunity that a lot of these kids will have by the time they leave high school, is getting some of their college paid for, and continuing this, if not a career, is definitely a hobby.